Hi, for this lesson, we are going to learn how to install Storybook for React. In order to install Storybook for React, the only thing that we need to do is to run npx sv, that stands for Storybook, init. This is the default command for install Storybook. This command will try to guess what kind of project it is. Because we already installed React, a React DOM, it is going to infer that it's a React project. So it's going to prepare all the needed stuff to install Storybook. And this is going to take a while because it needs a lot of dependencies. It needs to download them, install them, but we can take a look about what kind of things it's doing during the installation. For instance, we already have the stories folder contains a set of files that work as an example to understand a little bit how stories work, how you can create stories, on how you can visualize them in Storybook. Another file is the .storybook folder. That one contains the configuration of Storybook. And of course, if we go to the package.json, we can see that now we have a few dev dependencies that are necessary to run Storybook and two new scripts. The first one is exactly for running Storybook in the port 6006. And the second one is to build a Storybook, because your Storybook can be built as a static website. So you can deploy it and show it to your stakeholders, to your developer partners, in order to see some documentation about the components. So let's run the command. In fact, when you install Storybook, the first thing that they suggest you is to run that command. So here, because I'm working already with jar, it knows that that is my tool that I use it for run the scripts and for install dependencies. So I'm just going to run jar storybook. And this is going to show a storybook in the port 6006. And also the first time it takes a while. So while this is loading, let me just prepare myself and open the browser. So this is a storybook. As you can notice, there are two sections. We have the sidebar and we have the canvas. The canvas is split in two sections. We have the canvas and the docs. Basically, the canvas is the sandbox where we can play with our components. And the docs, right now, we can't see any difference because this is just markdown and is meant to be documentation itself. But if we go to the bottom and we see that we have different stories, and what we mean to stories is we have different states of our component. Or at least that's the idea, that you can show what are the different states of your company. For instance, if we have a button, we want to see how it looks as a primary button, as a secondary, as large, as small. If we go to the doc section as we are right now, we can see there is no any difference when I change those different stories, because the docs, as I said before, is just React only. We can explore here. This is auto-generate, and that's very important, and that's very powerful from a storybook. We can see the code, we can see the different props, what is the description, what are the default values, and also we can play with it and see this reflected here. If I change the size, for instance, you can see how it changes as soon as I just click the different options. In fact, if I want to check if it's primary or not, I also can play with it. This is because Storybook knows that those are props and is also able to recognize the prop types. Or even if you work with TypeScript, it's able to recognize it as well. But if we go to the canvas, we have different story represented in that canvas. And this is the sandbox. This is where you can play, start building your components, look how it's going to be, start also playing with the different props. Also, you have these different tools. If you want to zoom in, you can change this grid, or if you want to see if the component looks well in dark mode or in a different backgrounds, even you can check how it looks in tablet or mobile, or even you have measurements. Of course, right now is weird because I have a lot of zoom, but now you can see the different measurements of your component. And it's pretty handy. This is just for free for install this tool. Also, we can see here that they have different examples. I am going to clear this here. This is the header. It shows how it's logging, how it's logged out. But let's see how this looks into the code. So if I go into the code and I go to stories and I check, for instance, the header, I can see it's a pretty simple component. It's a component that is a wrapper. It has different props like the user, we have this user.name. That's what is going to print our component. So the idea of the storybook is like we can test and we can see how this component is going to look. As you notice, a story is a simple file that contains an export default that have the title, the component that we want to render, some parameters. We will talk about this later. And it's creating a template here. The template is a function that is going to receive some arguments and is going to pass those arguments to the component. Then it's creating the different states. So in this case, or states or stories, we have the logged in and the logged out story. And as you can notice, it's just a new instance of the template. And then it's deciding that now the username is Jane Doe. So if I go here to the sidebar and I check how it looks right now, I can change the story. I can say that the name is Guillermo Rodas. So what is the idea about this? And I can save, of course, and a storybook is going to reflect that here. I can test how my components looks. I can see how they look like this, how they look in, for instance, mobile, if I really like it, or even sometimes we might see all the time how it looks logged in, but we don't have an idea how it looks logged out. So it's really nice to have this state here or different states that are very difficult to replicate or to have in the real development or in the flow of the application. So you have some kind of history or a showcase to show the state of your components. And that's the nice thing about Storybook. So in the next lesson, we are going to learn how to add global styles to our Storybook configuration. See you in the next one.